Hi everybody, I hope you're good. So today we'll be speaking about email, SMTP, IMAP. So those are the messages protocols that you will very, very often hear when you're doing your everyday task. I'm sure you deal with one of those protocols on daily basis at least once. Okay, so after the HTTP, that we know the HTTP is a protocol that doesn't keep status of its connection. It needs cookies and stuff like that to keep state, to remember what happened, right? So we have the email service that uses some sort of other protocols, which are the SMTP or the IMAP. So they basically work as follows. We have the user, which is maybe you, who wants to send a message to someone, right? And in between, there's a server that will receive a message and send it back to the receiver. For instance, you have basically here the agent here that wants to send a message to another agent, but then we need to pass by a server, right? And the server will be the one sending back the message to some other clients, right? So we have the user agent, we have the mail service, and then we have the simple mail transfer protocol, aka SMTP, right? And now we have the user agent. It's like on the sender side, the user agent can be Gmail or Outlook, whatever you use usually. You have the mail server. Or you have the user agent, which is your computer. You have your mail server, which is one of those one I just mentioned earlier. And then you have the protocol to send your message. That's the thing. SMTP only sends the message. It doesn't do anything else. And then on the receiver's end, there's the mail reader, right? And then they are some other protocols that you have to do to receive the message and read the message, right? So this is very important. The most important part as well, you have to remember that Simple Mail Transfer Protocol or SMTP only sends the message across. Now, as you know already, you have what you call your mailbox. Your mailbox is a place where, or you can define your mailbox as anything you want in programming language, but it's a set of components that has your messages coming from the SMTP protocol, right? You have your message queue, and I'm sure that sometimes when you send your message to someone, sometimes there is no connection, so the message will go on to a queue. It will get held there until there is connection, until there is a handshake, because you have to remember that the SMTP is a TCP/IP protocol. So it needs a sort of agreement between the sender and the receiver before sending the message, right? So the message stays in the queue, but the message says knows exactly where it's going to. Now you have the SMTP. So the SMTP basically is that protocol that carries, it's like the post office, like a one-way post office that takes the message from one sender to the other sender, as you can see in this picture. It takes one message from this sender, which is one server, and send it to another server. That's how it works. So when I'm sending you a message from maybe my Gmail account, I'm sending you that from a Gmail server. So what you will do, the message will leave from Gmail if your message is to them. .vits.ac.za, you'll then go to the student.vits.ac.za server, look for your name, and forward it to you. That's the aim of the protocol, right? Now, we have now most of the we basically have most of the ways of sending messages, right? Sending message from the server. And as you remember, when you deal with a server or when you deal with a connection, you always have to know about its port. Here we will be dealing with the port 25, right? 25 to send our SMTP messages. Remember, this is a TCP/IP protocol, so you need to do a handshaking to have your message across, right? You transfer your message and then you close the connection, right? And after that, you are done with your message. That's basically it. The messages, they're usually in the ASCII format. And after that, you have the response most of the time that your message has been sent and received, right? That's one important thing. Now, but then, how does it work explicitly? Okay. So, Alice is sending a message to Bob. Right, and as remember what I was saying, Alice. Let's assume that here Alice is using Gmail. Alice is having an account on gmail.com, and Bob is having an account on students.vits.ac.za, right? So we want to send it to, okay, now, you know what, we want the message to go to Vits. Yeah. All right, so the message is going to Vits. So what it does, Alice will basically send her message to her server, the server where her email address has been hosted. In this instance, it is Gmail. So Alice will send a message to Gmail, right? And then in Gmail, the message will be basically queued in there, right? And after that, it will open a connection between this particular server and all of the stuff. But then in between, there's a whole lookup for this. Because when we have students dot vits dot ac dot za, so what it does, it has to understand the naming first. Za means South Africa, ac means institution, vits it's a university, we know where the server is. Student, it means that we're sending that to the student server, right? But then we'll be talking about that into the domain name system, the domain name service in the next part. But for now, you have to know that Alice's server looks for Bob's server, and then we'll send the message to Bob's server, right? And after it sends the message to Bob, then it gets processed into that. Look for the Bob email, because it's only Bob's server. And after that, it goes to Bob, and Bob will be able to read the message with any application that he wants. It can be that Android mail or any other message, all right, and any other application. Okay, so a bit of practicality, how this thing works under the hood. So this is a simple SMTP interaction, and there is no better way than showing you an example of how this thing works. So myself, I played around with this, and then I wanted to show you how it basically works. So let's assume that, let me stop this, and then I run that without saving. So what I'll do here, right, is to simulate that SMTP communication. So you see, on your left hand side, on your right hand side, you have a Wireshark, and I set Wireshark to basically look for SMTP protocol. So SMTP has a couple of keywords that you'll have to remember. You don't have actually to remember, but keep those in mind if ever you need to understand how SMTP works. So you have your hello, you have your mail, you have your exit message. I think it's quit. So when you start, for this instance, we'll be taking this. So we'll be using Telnet. Remember that Telnet is a way of accessing a terminal, a remote terminal, right? For this instance, we'll be looking for Gmail at port 25. Remember that port. We get in. Now we have a connection, and you can see, there we go, we have a connection. We have a connection, and this is the data, I mean, kind of the connection string that we used. So you see that this thing is using a TCP connection with the port 25. And these are the other details that you need to know about the connection, right? So that's exactly what you want to have. And you have your SMTP protocol that has everything you need for the connection to work, right? And I'll just write a little message here, which is hello. That basically initializes the connection between you and the server. Yes. And then we have a response, right, from the server. Yeah, and then we have the response from the server. Google at your service. Okay, that's great that Google is at my service. That's interesting. So you can do the same thing. I won't spend too much time on that, but you can see how how SMTP works, right? SMTP just sends the message across, but then does not basically receive the message on the other end, right? Okay, so, oh yes, we were using Telnet earlier to deal with the SMTP communications. Then it will be up to you now to go and try it out for yourself and see how it works, right? Cool. All right, so we saw the HTTP and we saw the SMTP. Those are two protocols that can be used to send messages, right? You can send your messages to the HTTP, simple. And you can also use a dedicated protocol for messages, which is SMTP. So we're saying here that HTTP pulls, because yes, so what it does, it usually gets, so the HTTP gets requests from a particular server, but this guy sends messages to a server, right? They all use ASCII, and they literally all use the same thing almost, right? But then just that one is dedicated for messages and one hypertext transfer protocol. It's only there for sending pages across, web pages across, right? But then you have now, like, you remember the HTTP has a request and a response, right? A request that basically asks for the website, for the source name, which do you want to download something? Do you want to push something? Do you want to get the web page or whatever? But then SMTP has a header and a body. So when you send a message, I'm sure you already saw that you need to tell where you're sending the message to, who you're sending the message to, where is it coming from, the subject, the CC, the BCC, and then we have the body of the message, right? So those things are very important. They are very, very important in the SMTP so that your message gets routed properly, right? And I'm sure at some time, when you send a message to people, then it comes back saying that you didn't find the email address. This is a lookup that we'll see again in the next part. All right. So as a summary, we spoke about SMTP, which is basically a simple mailing transfer, a simple messaging transfer protocol. That protocol helps you to send a message across. It only sends a message across. It doesn't do anything else, right? As you can see here, SMTP sends a message everywhere, and that's the only thing it does. But then when it goes to the user here, right, there's some other things that we need to deal with. We need to deal with what we call IMAP, or Internet Mail Access Protocol. RFC means request for comments. You can go and Google that and have information about that. So the IMAP is just a way of keeping the message and then sending that to the user, pushing that to the user. So pushing that to Gmail, pushing that to output. And I'm sure you already saw some other ones called POP3 or Post Office Protocol version 3. So those ones, when you set up your email address using your VITS email address, it asks you to choose between POP3 and IMAP so that it can pull your messages, right? If you do not set any of those ones, you'll be able to read your message and then it'll just disappear. But those ones, they basically keep them, as is written in this part here in the HTTP. In the HTTP, when you access your email through through Gmail, all of those things are already there. I mean, it's fine, although this is SMTP going under the hood there, but then the HTTPS forward slash www.googlegmail.com. Then you can access your messages and then you do whatever you want. The most important part is to retrieve them using any of those two protocols. This was the very end of the first part of the emails and SMTP. The second part will be basically dealing about how to look up for an email address or how to look up for a website. Thank you.